Welcome back again, and in today's video I will answer the million dollar question, that is, when will this pandemic finally come to an end? And to answer this question I had to do a lot of research. So I analyzed a past similar situation when there was such a pandemic, and based on that I found a common pattern, and in this video we will explore that common pattern and also try to realize when this pandemic will in all probability end. So now in the year 1918 there was a similar pandemic which had started in the city of Kansas in USA, and that was known as the Spanish flu. The Spanish flu killed almost 50 million people, and it was present when World War I was going on. So it lasted from almost March of 1918 till April 1920. Now we don't know the exact date when the pandemic actually started, but the common date which is believed when the pandemic started is approximately 4th March 1918, and that was sufficient to give us a deep clue into what had happened then. Now look at this chart very carefully. This was when the first wave of the Spanish flu was said to be started, and it started approximately around 4th March 1918. Some people say that there were few cases even in Jan 1918, but for now let us assume that this pandemic started around March of 1918. Now in any horoscope, Jupiter is the Jiva Karaka, that is, Jupiter is the reason why life exists on earth. Jupiter also represents the Akash Tattva, or the ether element, or the sky element. And when Jupiter gets severely afflicted or is trapped between malefic planets, then it can cause severe loss of life. Now, if you see this blue circle, you can see that Ketu is with Pluto, okay? And Jupiter is before Pluto and Saturn is after Pluto. Okay, now what is Jupiter? As I said, Jupiter is the Jiva Karaka. Pluto is a planet which represents the underworld. It represents death and transformation. Okay, and it's symbolized by a phoenix which represents rising from the dead. Ketu, as we know, is something which separates. And Saturn also, in a sense, is a malefic planet. So here we see a very close pattern that Jupiter and Saturn are in very close proximity to Pluto, and that is when this Spanish flu pandemic had started. Pluto was also with Ketu. Again, Pluto was in the sign of Mithun or Gemini at that time. You can see that Pluto is in the Rahu Ketu axis. Okay, and Rahu is the cause of viruses. Rahu is placed in Jupiter's sign of Sagittarius. So the first wave, which started on 4th March 1918, was not that severe. It killed almost 12,000 people, but it was not very severe. Now let us move to the second wave of Spanish flu. Okay, this second wave of Spanish flu started approximately around mid of August 1918. Again, you can see what has happened now. Jupiter has moved into the sign of Gemini and is in close conjunction with the planet Pluto. And Jupiter is helmed between malefics, that is Pluto, Saturn and Sun. Even Sun is considered a malefic planet. So you can see Jupiter, the Jiva Karaka, is helmed between Pluto, Ketu, Sun and Saturn, four malefics. Okay, and the second wave of Spanish flu was quite severe. It killed many people. And even at that time, the government had forced the people to wear masks, follow social distancing, etc. So you can see a pattern that Jupiter is in very close proximity to Pluto and Saturn. Now let us look at when the third wave of Spanish flu started. The third wave of Spanish flu started around mid of January 1919. Okay, and the third wave was relatively very mild. You can see that Saturn has moved two houses away from Pluto. Okay, but Jupiter is still in close conjunction with Pluto, and one house before Pluto you have Ketu. So the effect of the pandemic is still there, but because Saturn has moved away, this wave was relatively mild as compared to the second wave of Spanish flu. Now let us look at the fourth wave of Spanish flu, and this was the final wave, which started in December 1919 and lasted till around April 1920. Okay, now Jupiter has moved into the sign of Cancer, and he still held between two malefics, that is Pluto and Saturn. So still the pandemic is there, but it slowly ceases now. Now let us look at when the first case of corona was reported. So it was reported on 26th November 2019. On 26th November 2019, you can see that the Jiva Karaka Jupiter is placed in his own house of Sagittarius, but he is surrounded by malefics except for Venus. Okay, so Jupiter is surrounded by Ketu, Saturn and Pluto. Okay, Pluto symbolizes death, Ketu symbolizes separation, and Saturn also is a karmic planet which gives the results based on our actions. Now Jupiter is also trapped in the Rahu Ketu axis along with Venus. So in this case, Jupiter is completely surrounded by all enemies, that is Saturn, Ketu, Venus, Rahu, Pluto. Cases of corona started getting reported in China for the first time. So this pandemic might have started somewhere around October actually. Okay, and the first few cases started getting reported around November of 2019, and slowly by the time March had come, this pandemic had spread across the world. So again, for corona also, you can see that the Jiva Karaka Jupiter is trapped between Saturn, Pluto, Ketu and Rahu. So this is a common pattern, that is Jupiter is somehow getting trapped between Pluto and Saturn and Ketu. So now let us look at this diagram. Okay, now before I move to this diagram, one more thing is, on 30th March 2020, Jupiter entered the sign of Capricorn on 24th January 2020. Saturn entered into the sign of Capricorn or Makar. Pluto was also in the sign of Capricorn, and both Jupiter and Pluto were at 0 degrees on 30th March 2020 in the sign of Capricorn. This is when the government started imposing a lockdown in India. Okay, so again you can see that Jupiter is hemmed between the malefics Saturn, Pluto and Sun. After September of 2020, in India everyone felt that things will become normal. But around February 22nd, 2021, what has happened is, an Angarak Yoga was formed in the sign of Taurus, that is Rahu conjuncted with Mars in the sign of Taurus, which is nothing but the ascendant for India's horoscope. Okay, and this is when the second wave of corona actually started intensifying. And therefore, right now you are seeing great kiosks in India, that is in the areas of Delhi, Noida, etc., you can see very large number of corona cases. Okay, the same thing is happening in West Bengal, and somehow it is now controlled in Mumbai. But nevertheless, across India, the corona cases are still increasing as I am speaking and making this video. So you can still see that the Jiva Karaka Jupiter is trapped with Pluto and Saturn. Okay, and therefore these things are still happening. On 6th April 2021, Jupiter transited into the sign of Aquarius, but the Angarak Yoga was still into effect. Okay, and if you remove India's yearly horoscope, okay, when you make India's yearly horoscope also, the Angarak Yoga was present, and therefore the effects of Angarak Yoga, that is destruction due to viruses and corona, continues to persist in India. So right now Jupiter is in the sign of Aquarius, but what is going to happen is on 14th September 2021 Jupiter is going to re-enter into the sign of Capricorn. Okay, and he is going to stay there for a brief period, that is till 22nd November 2021 approximately. Okay, and therefore again he is going to come in close conjunction with Saturn and Pluto, and because of this I see a potential third wave of corona starting from 14th September 2021. Now on 20th November 2021, okay, Jupiter will again transition back into the sign of Aquarius, and he is going to remain there for a year. But you can still see that Jupiter is in close proximity with Pluto, and he is still present in Saturn's house. So Jupiter still has the influence of Saturn. Okay, therefore these 2 months, that is from 14th September 2021 till around 20th November 2021, the corona pandemic is again going to show severe effects, and I consider it as a third wave. So now the question on your mind may be, when is this pandemic going to end finally? To give you an honest answer, the pandemic cannot end so easily. Okay, Jupiter has to move at least 2 squares away from Pluto, and Saturn also has to move 2 squares away from Pluto. Now around April 20th, 2022, Saturn is going to transition into the sign of Aquarius. Okay, and again he is going to retrograde and re-enter into the sign of Capricorn or Makar around July of 2022. Okay, so at least till 2022, this pandemic will not go away, because Pluto will still remain in close proximity with Saturn and Jupiter. Around January of 2023, okay, Saturn finally re-enters into the sign of Aquarius, and he remains there for 2.5 years. So that is when the pandemic will start decreasing in its intensity. That is, after January 2023, the cases will go on reducing completely, and the virus will get completely eliminated by the end of Jan 2025. So, in a way, I would say the ending signs of the pandemic are seen to start around January of 2023, and the pandemic will completely end by the year 2025. Now, one more thing I want to add is, in Vedic astrology, the planet Pluto is not considered while making individual horoscopes. Okay, but when you want to see global events, you have to consider Pluto and Uranus, and that is where most of the astrologers have missed the point. Okay, Pluto is also known as Yam in astrology, and Uranus is known as Harshal. So Yama is nothing but the god of death, and Pluto in Western astrology also represents death followed by a transformation or regeneration. It's symbolized by a rising phoenix. Okay, and so as long as Jupiter or Saturn is in close proximity with Pluto, the pandemic cannot end. The pandemic will end only when Saturn and Jupiter have moved far away from Pluto, that is at least 2 squares away from Pluto. So friends, looking at the pattern shown by the Spanish flu and also looking at the conjunction of Jupiter, Pluto and Saturn, I can say that most probably this pandemic will completely start reducing after January 2023. And this virus will completely get eliminated only in the year 2025. So friends, hope you liked this video. Thanks a lot. We'll see you shortly with another video. For any consultation, email us at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com. To know more about us, visit our website astroseva.tripod.com. If you have not subscribed to our channel Kamath Astrology, you can do so by clicking the bell icon and you will be notified when we add a new video automatically. So friends, thanks a lot. Take care. Stay safe. Bye. We'll see you shortly with another video.